call to order the Lincoln Brady Board of Health on July 21st at 5:30. I guess the first thing I'd like to do would be to introduce our new health agent. Laura Vlasic is our new health agent. I was present on that one interview. She seemed to be very knowledgeable on the things that we would need to be called to call her on. She interviewed very well, and I think the consensus was for the whole group of us that interviewed that she was the person that we wanted to target, which we did. In the process, I was very specific that the health agent is the eyes and ears of the Board of Health. I mean, we depend on her to apprise us of what's going on in town, any health issues that need to be addressed. But there may have been some notion that she actually reports to us, which, I mean, technically, she does inform us.
She does report to us.
Well, technically, she doesn't report to us. She reports issues to us.
She's not
our responsibility.
To you. Absolutely not. It's in the personnel bylaws.
I'd like to think that we are all coordinating here and cooperating together, because we cannot function without her ability. We do have to appoint Laura to the position. Actually, we never did appoint John technically to the position, which we have to do also tonight.
Well, I would actually have a couple questions then, first.
Certainly. Well, I was going to ask Laura to maybe, you know, give a little background on what she's done and where she's coming from.
So I worked for the town of Malden and the town of Reading for a total of 8 years. I conducted numerous food inspections, housing inspections. I do lead paint, certificates of habitability, which is something that I know Reading doesn't do, but it's a pre-occupancy inspection that the other cities do. Mm-hmm.
So it's Everett and Malden, right?
Yes.
What were you doing? You were Everett the last?
Malden.
Malden. What were you doing in Malden? What was your position?
I was the senior inspector.
And then Malden, as you can imagine, is a much larger health department. So the supervisory piece of what we were looking for, Laura had that because she had a staff that she supervised.
How big of a staff was that?
5 people.
And did you have questions?
Yeah, I do. I guess then, and maybe this can be clarified by Cheryl Sabano. But my understanding is from Chapter 111, Section 27, the Board of Health is the local arm for both the state and the Department of Public Health. And that as a Board of Health, we actually appoint the health agent to act as our agent in day-to-day activities. Is that correct?
I believe that is correct.
Yep.
So I guess my question to you, Laura, is are you going to basically report to us or to the town manager?
Hopefully both, then we can all work together to make sure that everyone's needs are met and that everything is safe for the community.
Well, one of the concerns I have is the reason why the boards of health actually, both in our charter and state law, act independently is so the boards of health aren't influenced by any local politics.
Correct.
Which is why I guess I wanted to know whom you're going to report to, either the Board of Health or the town manager.
Why would that be different?
Because at times there can be concerns about a political influence for any type of health inspections or...
Well, our decision would have no basis on that, correct?
Well, that's what I'm asking, because we have to vote to appoint her to represent us in day-to-day activities.
Well, I would hope she would give us the information we would need, and also the town, but we would act independently of whatever the town's issues were. We would act on, the Board of Health would act independently with our own decision.
Whose direction would she take if there was a conflict between the Board of Health and the town?
Well, it's not a direction thing, I wouldn't think. She just has to give us the information. I mean, if she withheld information, I would think that would be a dereliction of duty. But if, when we have the information, we can act independently.
Yes. So I needed to clarify who she was reporting to.
So that, well, I mean, report to, she, we don't have authority over.
Another two directs her work?
No, it was really more in terms of the idea of we are the local arm for the Department of Public Health and for.
So you're talking about an informational sense?
Mm-hmm, yes.
I don't think anybody would have a problem with that.
Okay, just needed to clarify.
But in terms of prioritizing work, I think that's a staff decision at the end, with collaboration as appropriate.
The other question that I do want to ask, and I would like this to actually be something that is in our record, and this is really directed to the two of you, since you're representative of the town manager and the Board of Selectmen. Are you willing to authorize any expenditure of town funds to defend any possible legal suits that may be created or exist regarding our appointment?
Why are you raising that question?
I want to make sure that we as a Board of Health don't have any legal obligation or risk.
I can't answer that. I have no idea where that's coming from.
I mean, risk because of the information we get?
No,
or just risk of the acts we leave?
The actual appointment of.
Of the appointment.
Laura, yes, who would then be acting on our behalf.
There must be somewhere else the Board of Health would not appoint someone. I don't know if it's for sure, but.
Okay. And it's just more, it's a liability question.
Well, the town is a plenary coverage of liability, errors and omissions, I think, of any board member acting in his or her capacity. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, I've run into that on the CPDC, so I know they were covered. Got sued by a particular developer, like every week I get a big envelope at my front door. Mm-hmm. Town picked it all up, so I wouldn't be worried about that.
Laura and I have had discussions already about what we may do in the future as far as a board and with the town to try to get involved in the town, and we can go through that.
I guess one of the concerns too is we've lost three members of the board, I mean of the Department of Health in the past 6 months, and that's not good for the town, that's not good for anybody. So in bringing in somebody new, it would be beneficial to not have that kind of turnover. So I think, I don't know if this is the place, but I think management style needs to be a certain way, and now that's just not directed at you, that's a town thing, to prevent people from leaving, basically.
I'm not sure what you're referring to.
I'm referring to the last two people that left this department under.
Well, Joan retired.
She retired.
But she had been planning on for a very long time. She had talked to me about it on numerous occasions.
I know her story, and I know Donna's story too. And neither of those exits were respectful or kind or.
I think you're drifting into areas of personnel.
I am. And I would
probably
love to have
not be discussed on TV.
Yeah. So I can, we can go into executive.
No, you can't.
If it's personnel, when can I discuss it? I can't discuss it ever with the Board of Health.
It's nothing you have any purview over. So you can't go into executive session. You got to have purview over negotiations, personnel issues. You don't have any purview.
Okay. Anyway, I can talk about management style. Can I talk about that? Or is that out of the realm of this forum? No?
In general, I guess.
Okay, in general, I think there has to be a management style that will allow the health department to stay intact for more than a year. That's all. I won't go any further.
Well, I'll just add on to that, and this is really regarding our public health nurse, because according to a recent BU study, there's something like 24% of municipalities that actually don't have public health nurses. So the fact that we've actually lost Anna, I can't begin to really calculate the impact that's going to have on town. And being an advanced nurse practitioner, I can speak regarding her resume, because it is a resume that doesn't often come before us. And this is no offense to any of our excellent public health nurses that we've had in the past, but she was overqualified for the position. She practiced with professional autonomy, using excellent clinical judgment. And I think I can speak for all of the board members that I really regret losing her.
I agree.
Yes, I'm very saddened. Yes. Saddened that we did.
It's a big loss for the town,
because I don't think that you're going to be able to get another resume that even comes close to hers, unfortunately, with her certifications that will go beyond what the scope of this job required.
Yeah, her service to the town was exemplary. Absolutely.
As was Johnny's.
Yeah.
Well, we do have to appoint our health agents. Is there any motion to appoint?
Well, I guess I have a question. Is there a probation period that's allowed for our health agent?
That I'm not in the hiring process. Maybe we could give a as far as the
comes for the purposes of the board.
Thinking more through the board of health.
Yeah, for the board of health, the statute is the statute that
right.
health agent has to be appointed, mm-hmm. or we don't have coverage.
But internally, mm-hmm. there's
in
we
probationary.
Have a, yes, we have a personnel policy right. that covers that.
Yeah. But we're not involved in personnel.
Right.
Is what
this is just a requirement of the state that you make the mm-hmm. appointment.
And if we don't make the appointment, what do we have in terms of our...
That I'm not sure of.
In terms of that, might be something Cheryl Zabarro would guide us?
Who is Cheryl Zabarro?
She's our legal aide through the Mass Association of Health Agents.
Are you Cheryl?
Yeah. Oh. I just didn't know what that, you know, how that functions for us.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's statute that we do have to have, mm-hmm. that we do have to appoint a health agent.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I mean, we've been without a health agent for months,
mm-hmm.
so, you know, but, I mean, that would be a discretion of the board to appoint. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I, as of right now, I would like to move forward.
Mm-hmm. I have serious concerns in terms of our last resignation moving forward.
As far as the town's policy, or?
Just the appointment, actually. You know, I've been assured that Laura will report to the Board of Health. You're assuring us that the town is willing to, you know, fund any type of defense that might arise around this appointment without getting into anything that we can't
what,
talk about.
What, you worry about being personally sued?
If the board appoints this agent, is there a liability involved in doing so?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
But we can't talk about it.
Liability and performance of duties, you're saying?
By accepting
errors and
her,
omissions.
By accepting her to represent us.
Yeah.
Yes.
What liability might that entail? What's it? Give me a scenario. I'm just having a hard time following what you're saying.
That's a human resource.
Human resource issues.
Well, that comes under the department, so I don't think it, I don't think it extends.
That's not your purview.
All right, so if we did the appointment, we are not, quote, giving our blessings to something is what I'm, is my concern.
You're appointing under the statute.
Right.
So I would defer to the statute on what that, those parameters are on that appointment.
And that's actually what I'm referring to.
Do you have that statute here?
Exactly. I don't have the whole thing written out. It's chapter 111, section 27. Grants Board of Health independence to act as the local arm for both the state and DPH. Board of Health appoints a health agent to act as their agent.
Right.
Yes.
Essentially confirming the role as reporting to you.
Yes.
Yes.
But the hiring takes place separately.
The health agent functions as our agent. Yes.
Yeah, right.
Yep. And the statute, I think, lists out all of the various pools and camps and all the things that statutorily need to be covered there.
Right. So there were some concerns, I think, about communication, Laura, in terms of how that would flow with you and the board.
Yes, we've had communication, and I will impart upon Laura that, we do expect an open dialogue between all of us. I think that's already started. We can also work with the town, with the town manager's office, if anything arises that, we deem inappropriate.
But we can't, because that's personnel, right?
The nurse reports administratively to Laura. That needs to be firmly understood by this board. In all matters.
Right, but my understanding of public health nurses, they actually, they report to the Massachusetts Department of Public Health and also report to the boards of health.
Not administratively, in terms of hiring, firing, discipline, all that stuff.
But they're, they are in fact, though, legally liable to report to the Department of Public Health.
You kind of informational reporting.
Everything, their records, their treatment, their...
Treatment, what do you mean?
Donna actually does do, or did, all public health nurses do some treatment.
Well, I thought you kind of treatment of personnel. Yeah, that, yeah, I agree with that.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, this is where there's some differences from other boards.
Yeah. I'm sure you can work out an arrangement for that. I'm just speaking from the administrative point of view. And with respect to your former nurse, I think she was under the impression that she reported administratively to you, but she did not.
Well, reports, et cetera, are, yes,
administratively,
that's state.
In terms of being hired, fired, disciplined, directed. Asked how to do her reports, that's her boss's right to determine, totally.
But then I'm not sure, actually, through the Department of Public Health, they have a, and again, I would have to have the statute in front of me, but I do believe that's part of her duty, is to actually keep reports and data, and that's actually required by the state, that nobody else can actually interfere with that.
And those reports came to the board. We always got her reports at the board meetings. So that would make me think that it was...
Yeah, so I'm a little confused by what you're, what you're referring to.
I think you're talking about two different things. There's the technical side of the job for simplicity, and then there's the organizational side of the job.
Yes, exactly.
So the technical piece absolutely would flow as it may have been, and all the things that we've always done all along. There'd be nothing changed. We do have coverage. Well, Laura can update you on the plan for coverage that we've worked out. And as you know, since Steve DeLauro left in January, we've worked very closely with North Reading, with Bob Gracie. So we've had a very good working relationship with our neighbor to the north. And I think we're poised to move forward.
Do I hear, do I have a motion at all? next, first, we also have John Frelick as our, part-time inspector. John, could you just give a little, maybe a little word on what you've done recently and how often you work just for the rest of the day?
So I act as the full-time agent in Stone, and as of September 11th of 2016, I've been employed by the town of Reading, and I act as a part-time health inspector here. And my duties consist of anything that the, aside from the routine food inspections that we have, we, you know, again, we operate as directed by the agent, and I've worked with both Mr. DeLauro and Mr. Bracy, and I look forward to working with Mrs. Vlasic. And yeah, as far as my routine duties, I've been acting as a health inspector. I work 14 hours a week after my duties are completed in Stoneham, and I've just been operating as such since September.
Well, Laura alerted me to the fact that we didn't officially appoint you when you came to us back then, which actually we'll need a motion to appoint.
I'll make a motion to appoint, and I don't know if it has to be backdated.
Probably should.
Yeah.
To September of 2016.
Date of hire.
Okay.
If he did any official actions, I guess it'd be the first day he did anything official. Probably close to hire date.
Yeah, Reading Falls Free Festival.
Yeah, there you go.
And before we vote, do I have to officially designate Nancy has a voting.
I should make a comment that you're continuing it to designate her a full member.
Yes, we are continuing that.
Given that you're short on a person.
There is a motion on the floor to accept, appoint John Frelick as our second. All in favor of John, appointing John Frelick?
Aye.
All opposed? No. John, you're appointed our health inspector. And I'd like to just...
Mr. Chair, could I ask the board what additional information they would need to be able to take a position to make the appointment on the health agent? What unanswered questions, can we get a list of things that you're unclear about?
We could get a list, but I guess we can't talk about it in an open meeting, so I'm not quite sure.
This is about reporting, not personnel issues, correct?
This is about reporting for John, or I'm not sure?
No, reporting to your board.
Okay.
Or any official duties she has with respect to reporting to the state. That's what your appointment is about. So what are your questions that are not answered at this point? Makes you unable to make a motion?
Probably because of prior information that at least I have received as a board member.
Prior information?
Yes.
What is that?
I can't talk about it because it regards personnel.
You tell me.
Well, it can't be discussed here is what you've instructed me.
Just to be clear, can I speak for a second?
You may. Sure.
The matter that you're discussing that has nothing to do with the board, I am aware of, and I have seek legal counsel, and I am aware of my rights, and it has nothing to do with the board. So going forward, I would like to discuss matters that pertain to the board and the city and how we can conduct our jobs.
Are we prepared to do that?
I'm not prepared to make a motion right now, no.
Well, I would make a motion to appoint Laura Vlasic as our health agent. No second. So, my report. I did have discussions with Laura about the importance of our health inspections that we have and the staffing that we do have. I brought up with, we brought up before when we lost Joan, about who was going to be doing the inspections. So I've had a discussion with Jean and Laura regarding the scheduling, how they thought that would be accomplished. At the last meeting, I kind of thought that we should allow our health agent to take over and estimate, once she got her feet wet, how that would be accomplished. So, Jean, I know you said maybe July we would be getting it, maybe a plan for that?
Yeah, we have a staffing plan. Laura was going to provide it as part of her report.
Okay.
But we have been working collaboratively with the town of North Reading. So we do have coverage, and I wanted the board to feel reassured that we have the coverage that we need.
Okay.
And we will restaff.
And the inspections have been going well so far since you've been here?
I don't know if I'm supposed to answer. I haven't been appointed.
Good point.
Yeah, I don't know that without having a health agent, I don't know that, you know. When we have John Fralick, working hours a week, and we have some additional support through Bob Bracy.
Mm-hmm.
But
is Bob Bracy still doing inspections?
Yes, but the problem is that we wouldn't have any coverage during the day, so that they both had other jobs during the day.
And he had a job during the day when he was covering Reading also.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Also, I did speak with Brad Jones' office last mm-hmm. meeting. We had a discussion regarding one of the legislation.
Yeah.
That is still in joint committee. His representative did not think that there was a good chance that may not make it to the floor. I did register our opposition to that. That was the
mm-hmm.
the H-112.
Yes. So he said that he didn't, meaning that they didn't think it would even come up for a vote.
Possibly. It wasn't clear.
It would kill before it even came up for a vote.
It may die in committee.
May die, okay.
Can you just briefly say what that's about?
That was the bill that may usurp the Board of Health's authority for like Title V and wetlands
yeah.
Conservation Commission's wetlands. Actually, we would have to appeal to the DEP. I don't know if you're at liberty to even mention, or if you know anything
I've read about it, but okay. I don't know what that process would be.
But any stricter regulations than Title V would have to be submitted to DEP for approval. And actually, appeal would be sent. If there was an appeal, it would be sent to the DEP.
Yeah.
So, even though DEP, I guess, has been cut, the funding has been cut.
Right. I mean, I don't know who's going to do it.
Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm. Also, I did draft a letter to Speaker DeLeo, which I should have made copies of. But basically, just in support of House Bill 2864,
mm-hmm.
which is raising the legal age of tobacco to 21,
mm-hmm.
Prohibiting sales of tobacco in healthcare facilities. Basically, I didn't want to speak for the board, so
mm-hmm.
we wanted to just take a look at it before I sent that in.
Mm-hmm. And actually, there was a really nice article supporting this on our other who's got the glasses? Who's our other
Jason Lewis?
Jason Lewis's website in terms of supporting Boards of Health's actions on not only raising the tobacco but eliminating flavored tobaccos.
I just tried to make it very succinct. Didn't want to lecture him. I'm sure he's very aware of the whole process and what it is, what the bill is. Just as a follow-up on that, the CDC this past week, I don't know if you had seen it, but the headlines were the first decline seen in vaping among U.S. teens by CDC.
It was good timing.
And it was credited to the lack of supply or lower supply, I think.
The drop was significant, falling from 3 million in 2015 to 2.2 million in 2016. And overall, tobacco use had dropped from 4.7 million teens to 3.9 million teens in 2016. Mm. So the public health community's efforts have seemed to have done some good.
Nice to see the evidence.
Yes.
Yes, yes. And we can only continue, I guess. So now, as far as monthly reports,
did Donna leave her
report? I have not seen a report from Donna.
Okay.
Looks good. Thank you.
All righty, I will get that off. Dan, did you want to see? Just a little letter of support for. I could send you a copy of that.
That's the letter. Sure, that's good.
As far as our monthly reports, we don't have any monthly reports. Is that correct?
I do have monthly reports, but again, I'm not appointed, so.
Mm-hmm. Do you have the nurse's report?
I do.
So we can look at that because that's the nurse's report, right?
I'm not appointed, so I don't feel comfortable with passing that.
It's not your report, it's the nurse's report, so we can probably see that.
There's no one, with the position being vacant, I think it's, I'm relying on Laura's expertise in public health. This isn't my area, so the way that we've discussed this is that the nurse's report would go to the health agent, and the health agent would give the report of the staff to the Board of Health.
She passes it on, or he passes it on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, we're not going to be able to make any. We're not going to be able to make any progress on our town's projects if we don't discuss our reports. We do have our pesticide regulations that I have looked at, fairly extensively. We did get an opinion from town council.
I sent you the emails that I've gotten from the Marblehead via Gene. Hopefully, Gene had sent you the emails from the Marblehead.
There was one that I couldn't open. That might have been the one I couldn't open.
This is from Andrew Petty. He's their health director. Basically, good morning. This had to do with the fines that the town council raised concerns about fines.
Right.
Says, although it's a regulation, it's more like a policy as it only covers town-owned property. Quote, it is in the best interest of public health to eliminate the use of toxic pesticides in town-owned lands, ponds, roadways, to encourage the reduction and elimination of the use of toxic pesticides on private property, and to introduce and promote natural, organic, cultural, and management practices to prevent and, when necessary, control pest problems in town-owned land. The Board of Health can set the penalty as they see fit. Again, this would be if someone used pesticides on town-owned land. Mm-hmm. Because it just applies to town-owned property, it did not have to be approved by the state.
That's from Marblehead?
Yes. This is because they had theirs fully vetted and passed. Mm-hmm. So.
What did town council say about the fines?
He said that our town's general bylaws, penalties for violation of Board of Health regulations is $50 for the first, $100 for the second, and $150 for a third.
Payable by the homeowner or the company?
Because that's what we had wanted.
He did not opine on that.
Yeah.
which I think we actually sent back to them about that.
And this is the response that Andrew Petty gave me, asking that also about, did you have any issues with your pesticide charges being, fines being more than, say, for their food violations? Because the Marblehead violation, I think we talked about this last meeting, is a $500 first violation, $500 first violation, $1,000 second violation. And he sent back saying, no, town council had no issue with it, that the fines were set to be reasonable, even though they were more than what they charged for their food violations.
Just a technical question. Does Board of Health set its own fines? Do they have statutory rights to do that? Or does that have to go through town bylaw change?
I don't know.
Well, our town bylaw, our council says the town bylaw sets has penalties.
Okay.
As high as 500?
No.
That's Marblehead.
Yeah. See, I thought you were going to emulate it.
But see, I don't know what's the highest fine that the town charter allows.
I'd have
town.
To look.
Because it's got to be.
It says one under section 1.8 of the town's general bylaws, the penalty for violation of Board of Health regulations is $50 for the first offense, $100 for a second offense, and $150 for third offense. Mm-hmm.
So how is it that we can do tobacco regs much higher and things like that? Because don't we have much higher fines for tobacco violations?
It must be somewhere in the bylaws.
So that's what I'm saying, is I don't know if there's a way that we can find out what's the absolute upper limit of our fines, because I thought...
We could probably change the bylaw.
Because I think even the town clerk charges people more when they don't renew their dog license.
Yeah, the
to
fines,
be honest with you.
The fines are all established in that bylaw.
Right. So
by category.
Yeah. So this is, you know, something that we were trying to figure out how other towns did it. And so it was really looking at, well, what's the upper limit that the town has on any of their fines? There must be something for, you know, codes.
I don't know.
Okay.
Well, for celerity, should we just change the fines to our bylaw fines?
Could, and then we would have to then go through
general bylaw change
right. To change that.
Which is the majority vote of town meeting.
Okay. And I did invite, by the way, Mr. Reed to tonight's meeting. He's the true lawn manager, regional manager.
Mm-hmm.
I sent you all the picture of the violation.
Mm-hmm.
He did not RSVP.
I have an interesting true lawn story.
Yes.
True lawn was spraying one of my neighbor's lawns. She has a tree lawn that has no sidewalk. And he proceeded to spray that area. So I walked up and said, introduced myself and said, by the way, you know that is town property. He goes, well, my boss said, we can't spray between the sidewalk and the street. I said, well, more precisely, you shouldn't be spraying the public property. And there is public property regardless of whether there's a sidewalk. He said, I didn't know that, I'll take it up with my boss. So apparently they're not pushing that direction down to their folks on the street.
Now, is that public property, or is that just a...
There's an 8 to 10 foot right of way extending in from the curb away of every road in Redding.
Okay, but a right of way is still private property, correct?
No.
Town owned.
It was when the road taking was done, it was included in the taking. So it was taken as public property by eminent domain.
So they're not paying taxes on that, no?
Nope.
Okay.
Nope. They took 2 feet off. two feet off my lot.
It
doesn't
there.
Count their lot size. Put it that way. They took 2 feet off my lot.
John has to leave early tonight.
One other thing is there is no mention of any school property in our regulations.
Because we don't have to regulate.
Correct.
It's already regulated.
But just that was brought up by town council. So I was my recommendation or my suggestion would be to put that in the exceptions rather.
Well, because there is it's already covered. The town already has very specific regulations that are guided by the state for any school property or anything within a certain yardage of daycare centers where children gather.
Okay.
So that's why we just did the tree lawn, because the town already The town has already addressed that.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes, I was just for clarity, just in the exceptions. Pesticide, as an exception, pesticide use on school property as governed by the Mass General Law, whatever it is.
Okay.
And then just to be clear that we're not, you know.
It's not, right, because it's elsewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Also, as far as his, one of his opinions was, it's unclear that the Board of Health may lawfully regulate the conduct of town employees, not under the board's supervision, vested to the town manager.
This is not really anything other than their use of pesticides.
I think that if you look at that portion of the charter, section 5.2, that's where the point of what we were describing earlier is clearly stated, that it's administratively it falls under the town manager.
Right.
We all work for the town manager.
Right. Well, I mean, my recommendation would be just to take out in the bylaw, town of Reading employees.
Right, because it's really just about, right, it's just the use of town use of pesticides. And
correct.
That's where Bob Keating was helpful in terms of, you know, clarifying that the town does not use pesticides on a regular basis at all. And his only concern was for the treatment, I think we talked about, of the gypsy moth, was it gypsy moth?
Mm-hmm.
And we had an exception to that already put in here, that there could be use of pesticides.
There could be an exception.
An exception, and that would be, that covered then what his concerns were.
Correct.
Yes.
Yes, but just in the section four where it says prohibition,
then we'll just
the use of
that.
Application of toxic chemical pesticides by town of Reading employees. So I would, if we could just strike by town of Reading employees.
Okay.
That would make things clearer.
Now, which section is
section
that?
Section 4, IV.
4, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay.
By town of Reading employees, if we could just strike that.
Mm-hmm. And keep private contractors.
Correct.
Okay.
And or citizens, correct.
Okay. All right.
And there was one other thing as far as our authority to the proposed regulations appear to assert Board of Health authority over the use of town properties. The town has assigned care, custody, management, and control of town properties to particular boards, control of the remainder of the town properties to the town manager.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we are doing this as a matter of public health.
Exactly. It is in the best interest of public health.
It is a reasonable health regulation, which I think it is. But is this one of the things that we may want to coordinate with the town manager, and get their support or blessing that we can do this?
Well, I think we can do it because it is in the best interest of the public health of the community, but it would be useful to have the town manager sign on to it.
Yes.
Yes.
But I thought that my read of what the town council is saying is that the authority for this lies with the town manager.
Correct.
That's how I read it.
Correct. That's why I'm going to ask the town manager for his approval,
right.
Support,
yep.
Blessing, whatever.
Yeah. And the way I read it, though, is that if it has to do with the best interest of the public health, then that's actually where, in fact, the Board of Health acts in the best interest of the community.
So you're saying the Board of Health supersedes the town manager?
In the best interest of the public health.
I don't think that's what town council's saying here.
The state law actually supersedes town bylaws or anything like that.
That's the chapter 111. But that's
just pointing to what town council wrote and how we wrote it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, you know, well, to be clarified.
I can't imagine the town would have an issue with that.
I mean,
I mean,
we're trying to work together.
Semi-formal that we're, you know, we're together on this.
Right.
I understand that we could probably do it on our own.
Right, but it would be nice if town manager would think it's a good idea to not have pesticides used on town land.
Yeah.
He's probably going to want to understand the whole range of issues associated with that. Is it a cost burden to the town to do, you know, something else? And, you know, what does it all mean to make that kind of a determination?
Well, the town doesn't use pesticides on their town land now anyway. This is to prevent private contractors and private citizens from treating town land without the town's permission, as Dan's neighbor did. They were treating town property without the town's permission.
Right, so there should be no cost involved.
Mm-hmm. In fact, it could be a way of gaining revenue.
Right.
But maybe only 50 bucks at a time.
I don't know enough about the subject to really know what the issues could be, but I think...
Well, and I can have a sit down with Bob, I guess, and Phil, yeah.
I did mention it to him, and he said he really wanted to get a full understanding of what goes along with that.
So I guess, like other regulations, it takes sometimes longer than it should, and it is June.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been doing this for about a year and a half.
Right. So I think we need a timeline.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not Bob can follow the timeline, he's other, I'm sure, much bigger fish to fry. But
I don't even think he's seen it.
But I in the past, things have moved slowly when they're not timely. I mean, not when they're not imminent. So I think the board needs to decide how much time we're going to wait before we've gone back and forth. We've done some...
Because we'd like to have a public hearing, more so because it's useful education also.
Right, more than we're going to get money and this is going to be a big...
Right, it's education.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So we need to sort of... I mean, I would like to have a timeline. And so and then we're going to try to have a public hearing at this time, and then we're going to...
We do have to finalize our...
With the legal counsel.
Regulation.
Yes.
Right.
And that's, once we do that, then we can have the hearing.
Right, so
and
I think...
So what I guess my question is, what do we need to do to finalize it? What outstanding items are there?
What we're doing right
that's
now.
That's what we're doing.
Right,
that's
right now.
I'm trying to get
so,
this...
Right,
scratch
right now. That one
yes.
town employee
yes.
clause,
yes.
and then
keeping,
put the fines in.
Keeping our fines as what we have.
Yep.
We can always change them
yep.
later date. Yes.
And, I mean, technically, maybe we won't even have to change the wording on this as far as, I mean, if Bob has an, if Bob would have an issue with it, I don't know. I guess we could assert our authority if we wanted to,
but it would be nicer to have everybody
exactly.
support this.
Right.
Yes.
So let me talk to, I'll see if I can check
right.
in with Bob.
Okay. And then we could do what we did with tobacco and invite all interested parties.
Yep.
We've already had the weigh-in from Public Works. They weighed in. Jane and Bob both weighed in and passed. They only asked that once you have the final, everything through town council, you send them a copy so they can look at the final draft.
Okay.
They were part of this draft.
Okay.
So that was the only thing Jane had asked, once it's finally approved, is to send it to her.
Okay. Well, let me speak with Bob, and then I can get back through Jean for the time being.
Okay.
Let's see. Was there anything else that you had on that?
No, thank you. Yeah, because those changes would be fine then.
It would be nice to get that answer too about the who gets fined.
And again, I think it's just academic because this is not something that we're going to spend a lot of time being able to enforce. So
right.
I am less concerned about who's liable.
Mm-hmm.
As more is about getting this out as a piece of education
yeah.
for the community.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and he also just did bring up the Wendell
yes.
decision.
Yeah.
And I from just reading it, I don't think that had much to do with
that
what.
Also.
What yep. we are trying to do.
No.
That was more of use not in accordance with its labeled use,
yep.
which that I don't think has anything to do with what we're trying to do.
I just had that. I copied that out myself.
And then the Mass Pesticide Control Act, it does not authorize local regulation, but it also
here
does not forbid it.
Right.
So.
And this was actually from the Mass Association of Health Boards also. It just says local boards may make reasonable health regulations regarding pesticides, provided such regulations are not inconsistent with the Mass Pesticide Control Act. This is what they're recommending and going by. And we're basically within all of the confines of what they're suggesting. In fact, I'll give you a copy of this. This is the printout.
Yeah, I didn't, this is the one I looked at.
You may not have gotten the email.
I could not open this, is the one I knew.
So you can keep all of that.
Okay.
And that little blurb is from the Mass
I think the town of Wendell was provided that example because the Attorney General disapproved it.
Yeah, they were.
Because they tried to regulate where they were not able to regulate.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
They superseded the state's rights, and there was no reason to do so.
Right.
Yeah, that was wetlands.
Anything else on? Would you be able to draw up the final draft on that?
Okay, so let me just make sure that it's, I'm eliminating this time. I'm changing the fines, section 4, and what did you want me to do about the beginning? The schools. Where did you put the schools part, John?
I just had it on the exceptions. It is an exception, and I had it as like a number 3.
School property.
All right, let me just see.
Can we put a parenthesis already covered in the previous?
Well, I do state Mass General Law as the reason.
So show me where you put it, and I'll copy it from the yours. So I put it in the same spot.
I mean, I just had use as exemptions, use of pesticides on school property.
Okay, 1, 2, you put it.
I just put it as number 3, because there are 4 and 5 on here too.
Right, so as part of 3, you put it as part of 3?
No, I just made a separate number.
So
you could be.
I could recount and I'll make it number.
Yeah, you could put it anywhere.
Anywhere, let me just copy down exactly. As governed by Mass General Law C in 3.2b.
I believe that was it, yes. Then strike on section 4 by town running employees.
Right, I did that one.
And there's also on number of the exceptions, number 4. It says any town department granted a waiver shall comply. I guess I don't know if we need this town department.
I thought I had crossed that one out already.
Okay.
That's on.
That's the exceptions number 4.
I have 3 copies that have been rewritten, so that's the problem.
I'm not sure if this is the most recent one either.
Exceptions.
Are you talking about the last paragraph? Any town department or contractor granted a waiver?
Yes.
Here under shall comply with all the laws.
I just wanted to strike any town department.
Okay, get rid of any time.
Just because we don't have that authority, and I don't want to challenge that.
Okay, I'll strike it.
And I will try to get an audience with Bob at some point in the next week or so and see if we can just get that, answer his questions.
Okay.
And
let me make sure there's nothing else that I get from last time.
Can run it back to town council to make sure he's okay with it, and then maybe a public hearing.
Good. Part of these with Marblehead, that's why. So where it says fines, so should we then just do what were the fines that were listed? Subject to a fine of $50 for first offense and $100.
Section 1.8 of the town's general bylaws.
1.8. 1.8. Okay.
penalty for violation of Board of Health regulations, $50 for the first offense, $100 for a second, and then $50 for a third.
Okay. All right, I'll get this back to you, John.
Very good. And we do have minutes approval.
Yep.
From the, from the last meeting.
Thank you, Darlene.
I'm a little confused on the agenda. Are you doing minutes and then open discussion, or do we have to do open discussion?
Let's do minutes. I kind of.
I'm just trying to think, everybody's here is on the clock, so.
Oh, okay.
Then you get double time.
Okay, if we're gonna do open discussion, you might.
Anytime.
Staff to stay.
Did you want to do open discussion first? Or minutes shouldn't take long.
No, that's okay, whatever you want to do.
Let's see, has everyone had a chance to read the minutes of May 17th?
Yes, thank you.
I didn't see any problems. Thanks, Darlene.
And just to follow up, the Reading Post, I know, put in the article, recycled our pesticide article again, but I do not get the Chronicle, so I don't know if it was recycled or not, so.
I don't get the Chronicle anymore.
But that was. So that was recycled in also. And then I sent you both articles on, through Jean, both about the dogs and pesticides, and on the requested one you had about ticks.
Okay.
So.
Have those been sent in yet, or?
No, I sent them to you via Jean. So they both went to your mailboxes.
Okay.
Through Jean. And I will resend them to her for you.
Okay.
Okay. For you to review.
Very good.
Okay.
And would, I'll send them to the papers.
You have to go through the ombudsman first.
They haven't been.
Yeah, you can't put out a release without.
Right, they have to be.
They haven't been, those have not been put out.
No, because I wanted you to review it first as the chair.
Okay.
Yeah, and I didn't know what you wanted to add, because you're the expert.
I am.
So. So that's why I sent them to both of you.
I didn't know what to do with them at that point. Do I read them and send them back to Jean and then?
Send it to John.
I can send it directly to John?
No, you can send it to Jean after you add, whatever you want to add to it.
Okay. Yeah, it's better if it goes for staff.
Yeah. Because you're the expert in what you wanted to add or change on that regarding canine exposure.
Yes, okay.
Any motion to accept the minutes of May 17th?
I make a motion to accept the minutes for May.
A second.
If you have anything to send me, if you could send it to me in the next day, because I'm gonna be out of the office for an extended amount of time, so.
Okay. Can I, what's today, Wednesday?
I'll be in the office till about noon time tomorrow, and then I'll be gone for.
Okay. I might have to send these rewrites to Darlene then, because I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this done tonight.
Mm-hmm. So can we do it through Darlene?
I'm going to send the corrected to Darlene.
The pesticide regulations? And then Darlene can send them
to
the chair?
To the chair.
Okay.
Because I know I won't be able to do this tonight.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Motion on the floor to accept the minutes of May 17th. Any discussion at all? Or? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? No. 3-0. Done. And as far as open discussion, I had some of this allotted time for the health reports and maybe the recommendations. But any other open discussion from anyone? Okay, well, that's all I have then. The meeting is adjourned.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.